Hey guys, good morning. Welcome back to my channel. Just had an early morning run with the kids. They're going to school. Got Tilly Rose here.
Yeah, and I'm going to the Apple store today to do some programming type stuff.
Yeah, that sounds cool, Tilly. I hope you have a good day. I'm just gonna quickly sort some stuff out because we need to sort out Deshane's school trip as well. He's up front, he's trying to walk fast. Shane, say good morning.
Shane.
Shane Hemmings.
Turn around for a second.
Oh, good. Well, I'm not even gonna say anything about Shane. So I thought, yeah. I seem to walk in and out of breath. So, I know. Hopefully, I get a bit more in shape soon. But looking at my hat, guys, and digged it out on my winter collection, and rocking it today. Basically, I've just sent the kids off to school, so they've gone. Just on my way home. Just bump into my parents from the school, very lovely lady. Just get say hello, gave me a hug and everything. And sometimes it's just good to get out and have a bit of fresh air. So weird, because basically, basically, I am like a people person and everything, and it's fantastic at times. I love people, and then you know, completely off topic, because sometimes I kind of want to be that person that got a lot of friends, and because I used to be, but that comes with its own negativity, which does bring a lot of unnecessary stuff. So I kind of try to avoid that, and I've turned into a bit of a loner, to be fair. You know, there's great people out there, like I said, and that's very supportive, very loving and kind to me. But I don't know, I've kind of like got to a point in my life where, because of trust issue, you don't know who to trust and all of that. So you know, sometimes the good suffers for the bad in that sense. Sad really, because I used to be so open and friendly when I was younger, and up until a point recently as well. You know, stuff that's going on, sometimes I can't go in depth about it because, one, I don't want to give the same people, you guys wondering what this is, it's a leftover croissant and juice from what I gave the kids. Well, yeah, like, don't want to come every year or every time they decide to spring up their nasty self and give them airtime on any of my platforms. I just want to kind of like try my best, not even. And you know, for YouTube, you guys are there, it's not even aware of certain things, so it'd be a bit unfair for me to move that kind of negativity on my channel. So you know, I'm definitely gonna try and avoid that. But yeah guys, like, you know, have some viewers that watch just to see what I'm up to, and yeah, use that information in not the best way. So yeah, there's a lot of, you know, what I'd call envy, and for me, I know rich is coming in many forms, so I count myself as rich, guys. And that's without the money, because I ain't got none. But yeah, I count myself as rich. I'm aware of my blessings, and I give God thanks for it. And anybody that comes in my life and try and take stuff away, that's only gonna affect me momentarily. I'm more wiser than that. Yeah, sometimes people swoop in trying to play the hero when they're the villain, etc. It's a joke, it really is. But yeah, all in all, in this little clip, I just, you know, there's people out there that's genuine and they're my friends, and they've noticed that I've locked down and all of this. It's a protection mechanism. I'm a Cancerian, so my star sign is a crab. Yeah, so, and there's one main thing that I thought of, and I thought, wow, you know, things just shooting back to my memories when things is happening. And if I trust my first instinct, guys, if I trust my first instinct and a lot of things, I could hardly go wrong. I'm telling you, like, always been like that. And I've always wanted to move away. Always want to move away from my family. Always. The amount of times I can remember, I've moved away. And you know, they do everything to get me back, and I didn't look into it at the time, but you know, I kind of know why now. It's revealed itself why. But yeah, people out there, they want someone worse than themselves, and then they don't care if it's your kids. And you know, Lord knows my heart, sorry. And always try to do things from a good place, not a negative place. Always. Whether anything to do with discipline, and you know, I'm not perfect, people, by any means, but always try to do things from a good place. Yeah, I know it's a bit of rambling, might not make any sense to some, but or it might make sense, you know, it's not that cryptic. But yeah, I'm back at home now, so I'm just gonna go in and wait till a certain time, then I have to go back in town. So I'll see you guys. Look at that light in there. Why, it's too bright. I'll see you guys in the next clip. Hey guys, so I'm now in lighting. I'd be squinting my eyes. Just pop into town to sort those final stuff out. This is like a double take, because at one point I left the paperwork that I need to sort out. Can you imagine, people? So this is like a take two situation. This is basically park, anywhere we can find park here. And we got our hour, and After the hour, then we'd have to pay. So we have to. We're not really gonna stay more than an hour, innit? So there was what park there. So I'm just gonna stay down here, do what I need to do, probably get a bit of shopping. I need to get some stuff to do some washing. My house looked like a shithole. Sorry people for my language. So that's need rectifying at some point. I'm not looking forward to that. Yes, I just need to do a few things and then get to back home really. Hey guys, just got back into my house. I am starving. It's just been a busy day. I didn't even get to come back to you guys and talk because I was hanging with one of my friends and stuff like that as well, which was really lovely. She came to see me. Got everything that I needed to be done. I had to concentrate because sometimes I was forgetting stuff because, you know, my mind is not the best. So I had to kind of concentrate. So I didn't really get to vlog throughout the whole process or the whole time I was there, which I would like to, but I had to just concentrate and all I needed to do. Just got a drink. I'm literally starving. This drink's from Marks and Spencer's, just like mango and orange. Which is really good. I've tried it before. Orange juice and crushed mango. Yeah. So I'm just gonna drink this, and I've had some leftover food. I'm trying to reheat it now. I didn't want to spend money on food. Sort out what I needed to sort out. Pay that bill I really needed to pay before it escalated into something negative. Picked up my daughter's shoes. I'll show you guys the box because I had to get it delivered. They didn't have it in the size, so yeah, picked that up. When I was coming out the store, the detector went off because apparently there was something in there, and I was like, you know what guys, sort it out because I don't want to go in other shops and I keep going off. So they sorted that out. Love the shoes, really nice winter shoes. That could keep the weather off her feet. It's really nice, really pleased with it. Could go for like going to church or whatever not, but it's like in the winter time, but I'm doing it for school basically. Yeah, that's like take. Because they walk themselves to school, so just making sure that as the weather gets colder, she's protected and cool a bit better. And got two treats. They love sweets, so I've got these. They were like reduced as well, so I don't know how much they were previously. Like paid £2 for it. And this is my little treat when I'm feeling a bit like a bit of chocolate. And they've got Remy Martini there, so that's why I grabbed it. A bit pricey, but you know, $3.99. It's my kind of thing, so guys, I got it. I've got some other stuff as well from Life of the House. Went into brand and got pick up a few things that I needed, like Dettol spray, stuff like that. But all in all, guys, you can hear my thing that I'm reheating, like it's frying, so, which I don't need. I just needed to steam, so I need to go and check on that. It's a really good day. It's good to see my friend, and my other friend rang me on the phone and stuff like that. I had a good little chat as well, which I appreciated. And old friend from a long time, way back friends. Yeah, so good friends. So yeah. Saying, you know, don't shut yourself off or close away and all of this. You know, I just have to take one day at a time because got problems trusting people, so I just have to take one day at a time. And sometimes I put things out here, I probably shouldn't even say certain things in depth, but yeah, a day at a time with all that is thrown against me, whatever reason, but I'm determined to just carry on and living my life how I want to, in that sense, like, you know, use a style, style of living, style of how I've always been. I just want to go back to my natural self. I don't want to be feeling like I'm doing things to please other people, not myself. So, you know, yeah, got a knock on the door, so I'm gonna go. Hey guys, good morning. Right, I got up today and, you know, helped get the kids ready to get out for school and had my bath. I had a really good bath this morning and, you know, I am feeling so psyched today because I've been listening to some good, positive, uplifting music. Yeah, so I am going to do something today that I've been procrastinating on for a long time, a long time. I've had this machine for a while now. It's my sewing machine. It's right here, guys. Yeah, so got my scissors here. You guys might recognize that scissors, and I'm gonna open it up and see what's cooking. I had a little bit of training before I went on holiday with this lady. She's a really good lady. You know, she showed me a few basic stuff and stuff like that. And what I loved about actually going and learning with her is just her zeal and her passion. And, you know, she was just a really nice lady. You can see her oozing positivity, even though obviously life is not easy and stuff like that. It's just, you know, it was just a great little moment to be around her and her teaching me how to set up a machine and stuff like that. So hopefully I remember, because I do find things like this a little bit intimidating. And I don't know if it's because it's kind of like, you know, it's a machine kind of things. I don't know why I'm kind of a little bit scared. When I was learning with her, actually, I wasn't as bad as I thought, building up to the time of going. But yeah, I'm just going to open it. I'm probably not going to do it in camera. I'm not sure if I'm going to do that on camera. But basically, the reason behind me showing you guys is to let you know that one of the things I wanted to get done, I'm noticing that I'm coming up to 50 subscribers. I'm so anxious because, you know, I promise you guys to make sure I do go ahead and do a little giveaway. And it's something I wanted to make. And I was like, you know, like seeing that I'm creeping up to 50 subscribers and kind of like panicking my mind thinking, oh my gosh, I've made the thing that I wanted to give away. You know, today I just got up and decided, let me get my machine out, see what I can do. If I'm able to make that thing I want to give away, it'd be amazing, because it's a project that I want to work on in the future and see where it takes me, to be fair. So maybe like my first thing, if it's a good job, you know, I reveal it later on, hopefully, if I conquer it. If I don't, I will still reveal it, because it's something, like I said, I want to do in the future, basically. So I'm going to just go ahead and do a bit of practicing on the machine. I'm going to open it up, do my practice, and let you guys know really how far and I got. And what's happening, really. So I hope that's clear enough. Bottom line is, I want to try to start learning a new trade, which is sewing, and I want to start making a particular product. And yeah, that product, I want it to be one that the first set is to do a giveaway two people, like I've mentioned before. One is, I know who it is because it's the first person that ever commented on my channel, and the second person will be absolutely random. I'll figure out how I'm gonna go about it. Like I said, the time is creeping up where I can see my subscribers just growing, and I'm a little bit anxious, so I'm gonna get cracking and see what I can practice and do. One of the things that I kind of get a bit of help with when I did go and have that session with the lady that does this teacher sewing, was she kind of showed me the basic way of going about achieving this particular product, and kind of like watching other programs to see if I can learn more as well, because like I said, I'm a little bit not terrified, but yeah, anxious maybe is a better word, about whether or not I can pull it off. So yeah, I've decided to show you what I'm working with. Basically, I took the machine out of the box. Box is now empty, so that can go aside. Okay. Comes with its instructions. It's a bit intimidating, like I said before, and a few stuff in there, and I'm not sure if it's even, I think it got a needle in there already, and this is a spare one with some other stuff in there, like the bobbin and some other little bits and pieces. I'm not sure what it is. I'll learn in the future. So guys, I'm just gonna take it out the plastic thing. Oh, I think, yeah, that's the foot pedal. I've got some other paperwork as well that I need to go through for. So basically, hope you guys can see, that's what the machine looks like. So as you guys can appreciate, because I'm a bit of a novice, it's gonna take me a little while to kind of like go through the paperwork and trying to feel a bit more comfortable and confident. I'm always getting copyright on this channel. I'm just gonna let it play. So basically, I hope you guys can hear me. My background is Christianity. I very much believe in like faith and hope and those kind of things. And you know, if you have a heart of repentance and stuff like that, God will always give you second chances and stuff like that, and about repenting, believing in Jesus. That's my kind of background. I wanted to kind of say that. Bear with me a sec, I need to press stop on that music. So I'm probably gonna get copyrighted for the music I had in the background earlier, but yeah. So yeah, this is it. This is where the magic hopefully is gonna happen. Colorers, you can do it. Yeah, you know, let me not come doom and gloom and start preaching, but yeah, I think it's important for me to say about my background. It's Christianity. Had a really good upbringing in terms of, you know, having that to go to instead of other things, having that faith. You know, sometimes when you're going through hard times and you're down and you're low, are you depressed and stuff like that, and you feel like life is just dragging you away, I give God thanks for that upbringing that I had, you know, and my mum taught us to pray, and and music in her background. You know, I'm Jamaican by birth. I live in the UK now, guys, for those who doesn't know. And my background, we love music, you know. We love music, whether it be Christian music or other types of music. It just heals. And even when you look on her roots, like going way back, that's a big part of it as well. So, yeah, I definitely want to kind of bring that side to me on my channel. In terms of letting you guys know my background in my beliefs and stuff like that. I don't go to church every Sunday. I've sometimes few and far between, guys, but you know, thank God my faith never leaves me. I can always go back to it, and definitely want to try and start going back to church and bringing the kids, because even that, you know, they have that background as well, but maybe not as strong as mine. So I know that I really need to work on reinforcing that, because sometimes when you're going through hard times and stuff like that, you know, I've seen God's work so many times, you know. I'm not fooled by anything else, like, because I can testify, I can confirm with great belief and authority of his work. So, you know, when you have that in you, sometimes no matter how things, life, people, whatever the case may be, might try to squeeze the life out of you in whatever form or way. I am so thankful and grateful that I have that side, that I can know that, you know, nothing is impossible with God, and no matter what they do, they cannot take away my belief or my faith. So it's just really a blessing that I can feel free in that sense, that no matter what's been thrown at me, or no matter how somebody thinking, oh, I'm going to clip their wings in that way, or I'm going to remove this from their life, or, you know, stuff like that. I hope you guys understanding what I am trying to say.
If it takes him 20 years, because the Bible said if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things have passed away, behold, all things have become new. So guess what? I'm not just waiting on God, I'm waiting in God. Because I know he holds my destiny.
Sorry guys, I love this song that's coming up, so it's definitely going to be a copyright situation.
Early one morning and Father in prayer. I had finished the prayer on Tuesday morning, and I had raised the sacrificial offering in the presence of the Lord, filled the room, and I was going through a mighty trial at the time, and the Spirit of the Lord dropped these words and this song in my spirit.
I'm going to turn it up a little bit more so you guys can hear.
And it has become my anthem. And when I can't see my way out of a situation, and the devil trying to make me frustrated because it looks like God ain't moving, I turn around and tell him, devil, I don't mind waiting.
I don't mind waiting.
Somebody just start shouting that. Shout it back in the face of the enemy. Let the devil know that whatever you try, it ain't going to work.
Remember somebody said to me, don't sing on my videos. Well, guys, at the end of the day,
I don't profess to be a singer, but you know, and I'm sure you guys know that. I'm just singing because I'm feeling the song. Amen! Mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. And that's in all my situations. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. Sometimes I do feel like most people should have that opportunity to have faith and have that thing. It's better than depending on something else that's not positive, like drugs or alcohol. You know, I think when I analyze situation, I feel blessed that I'm in this position, that I don't have to rely on other things. I'd rather go and listen to my uplifting song, you know, if you had to choose and stuff like that. Out of all the things that they have around, I'd rather stick to my faith, you know? And when you have strong belief, strong faith, and it will help you when the road get rocky. Hey guys, you would not believe it. I thought I might have to come back and tell you what I've got up to with the machine, how I got on with like stringing it up and everything. I think I've done it. I just can't believe it. Let me turn it around a bit. I can't believe it. I think I've done it, guys. So I'm just gonna go ahead before I even talk about this little cute thing that I've got as part of building up my little collection. I'm gonna kind of see if I've gone wrong. This is a piece of material that I learned a bit of stitching on from the lady that I told you that I went to have a little session with. Basically, you can see the sewing. There's like three sewings on there already. I'm just gonna go ahead and probably fold it again over there. Basically, I'm testing out whether or not I'll string this machine up properly. So yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and see if I can do another little stitch on there to be like the forward stitching on this material and see how I go. Oh my gosh, this is the moment of truth, just to see if I actually did go ahead and string up this machine by myself properly. Okay, I haven't switched it on or anything yet, so I'm gonna do that first. There's a little switch at the side there. Alright guys, it might not be a straight perfect stitch because I'm a little bit nervous, but I was just gonna say I am going proud of myself, but let's just see if this thing is gonna stitch. All right peeps. Oh gosh. Here goes nothing. Okay, I am meant to lower the needle. No, actually, no. Let's see, guys. I take my time. Guys, have actually stringed this machine up the right way. I'm a little bit nervous, so I'm going to switch it off first before I raise the needle and show you. I just can't believe it. So I'm going to take my time to slide it out. Okay. There's a cup thing on the machine as well, but I'm just going to snip it here just to show you guys. And I'm seeing quite a bit of treading, but guys, look at my stitch. I'm so pleased and so proud. I've actually string up my own machine, and you know, the only thing I had problem with was the bobbin, until I just took my time and kind of done it and followed the instructions on the pamphlet. And guys, I just want to show you again. I'm so proud of myself. So proud of myself. I thought I had to come and go over this another day. So I'm feeling a little bit confident. It's not like I'm going to start showing sewing on here, but I will show finished products, hopefully. So I'm going to take my time. But I'm so, so proud. I've actually stringed my own machine up from the little lesson I got one time of being. And my brother's a sewer as well. Just wanted to point that out, because when I went to Jamaica, I was like, went down to where his workplace was, where he has his business, saw his machine and stuff. Didn't really train, he just showed me to sit on one of his heavy duty machines. I can't remember what it was. And I was talking to him about stuff, and I had a little 2 minutes trial of that machine. I can't remember what it does. If I remember in the future, I'll let you know. But yeah. So now I'm just gonna try and crack on, keep practicing, reading, watching videos, and see if I can actually accomplish this. Guys. Maybe, like, you know, certain things come tricky for certain people. Maybe, like, some people think, oh God, Rose, stop draining it. I'm making a mountain out of a molehill. But this is such a proud moment for me. Yeah, I wanted to show you guys my cute little thing to put my pins on. Guys, yeah, you know, I've got catering background, I've got caring background. And I went far in the catering, but I wouldn't say I've mastered like qualification wise in the caring. I'm a very good carer, all of these things, but I want to trade, and you know, one day at a time, guys, one day at a time. I'm not gonna start blowing my own horn or wanna get carried away with myself, but you know, yeah, I literally had to come back because I was going to end my vlog in a previous clip, but in the same day I've sat down and I've figured out how to string up my own machine, and I can actually do little stitches and just take changing the dial for each stitch. So I need to just read up, have a bit more practice, and guys, I should be on my way. I'm feeling a little bit accomplished today. Yeah, guys, so anyway, if you like my video, go ahead and give me a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, follow my journey, leave comments, you know, let's keep it positive, guys, etc. Yeah, one day at a time. Yeah, that's all I can say. One day at a time. There's even some, but let me not chip into it. But yeah. Blessings, love, peace. So, so proud. So, so proud. Yeah, because I did find this a bit intimidating, guys. I'm not even going to lie to you. I did find this absolutely intimidating. Let me try and turn myself. But yeah. Take care, guys. Bye for now.